A controversial tax on businesses in Seattle.
$500 per employee per year.
Seattle's silly city council just passed a new head tax on its 600 biggest companies. We need the money, say the politicians, to provide apartments for homeless people.
We are ready to fight. Housing is a human right.
Are you with us?
Yeah!
Let's keep fighting.
This councilwoman, a member of the Socialist Alternative Party, led this protest.
Housing is a human right.
Seattle does have a problem with camps of street people. Homelessness has doubled in the last 8 years.
About 4,000 people living on the streets and in vehicles.
There are many reasons for that, but one is that Amazon and other companies brought so many new jobs to Seattle that the demand for housing exceeded the supply. Normally when that happens, builders are thrilled because prices go up and they quickly build new housing to sell to the new workers. Win-win. But in Seattle, politicians make that very difficult. Seattle's building code is 700 pages long. It says things like welded splices must be made of a certain kind of steel. Foam plastic signs shall not be greater than a half inch thick. Then the residential building code is another 700 pages. Can Seattle relieve its housing shortage by building more skyscrapers? No. In most of Seattle's land area, high-rises are illegal. Zoning rules say only single-family houses may be built. Seattle's big government restrictions created the housing problem. So now they want to solve it with more heavy-handed government? When the politicians proposed the head tax,
Amazon announced it would pause construction on its new building downtown pending the final decision.
Amazon's web services boss said,
you know, what company is going to want to start or move to or grow in a city that penalizes them for hiring full-time employees?
Good question.
No head tax! No head tax!
Construction workers started protesting against the head tax.
But if we fight against each other...
No head tax! No head tax!
Supporters of big government aren't used to protesters drowning them out.
No head tax!
Can I make an appeal? Can I?
No head tax!
Still, in Seattle, plenty of leftists are ready to march in the name of class warfare.
Pitting workers, against their own class interests.
Amazon's executives, they say, are behaving like mobsters. For stopping construction, they should be prosecuted for extortion.
Shame on Amazon and Jeff Bezos for holding construction jobs hostage in an extortionary threat against the city.
They call Amazon the enemy. Give me a break. Amazon created the jobs that the politicians now want to tax. If a company says tax is too much, we'll leave, that's extortion?
It is extortion from Amazon.
Come on. If anyone's acting like mobsters, it's the politicians. At least America has some tax competition. If politicians in one city or state get too greedy, people can move elsewhere. A few years ago, when New York politicians raised taxes, Donald, not yet President Trump, told me, rich people will eventually just leave.
You haven't left.
I haven't left yet.
Are you going to leave?
Big story if I leave, I guess. If I leave New York, that's a big story. Look, the rich people are going to leave, and other people are going to leave. You're going to end up with lots of people that don't produce, and then that's the spiral. That's the end.
He was right. We don't want the spiral. If wealth creators leave, then there's no one left to tax. Monday, Seattle's politicians finally realized that. Sort of. They said, okay, we won't take $500 per employee. Now it'll be just $275. That adjustment was enough to get Amazon to resume its construction in Seattle, but it says future expansion's now in doubt. Seattle's taxes and rules are a reason that Amazon will build its second headquarters someplace else.